Let's go see if he'll cooperate. Yeah, the one area where we went frog fishing, there's miles of slop and junk and pads and everything to cover there. You could spend a week there. You're going to be able to cover a lot of water with a frog, making those long bomb casts and working them back, and you should be able to come up with something eventually. Got him! There we go. Oh, he took it too. There's a frogfish. So they're slowing it down. See that? First retrieve, I slowed it down. Bang. Believe it or not, after severe lightning storms, what I find a lot is that the fish will migrate to overhead cover. Got onto it once. I think it was the hurricane that went through Bob Cajun once. The next day, we were out in a tournament on Tri-Lakes, and we fished different areas. And nothing. And then we went to this one little pad bed, and it must have had 30 fish under it. We could all see them swimming around it and in it and under it. I couldn't believe it. I'd never seen it before. Well, we'll try some shallow and see if we can't get a pattern going here soon. I was out here on Monday. The water temperature was 67 degrees. 2 weeks ago was 84, or a week and a half ago was 84. Yeah, it dropped. It was a poverty bite. They were very slow. The way I was getting them to bite was just I was frogging and then getting them on a follow-up with a jig or something. Yeah, they wouldn't commit on a frog, but at least they'd show themselves. Which makes it that much easier. I like junk fishing though, like pads and slop. And I like all kinds of stuff. Wherever the fish are biting is what I like to be fishing. Oh, that was a fish. Just out in the middle of nowhere. Give him a minute or two to gather his thoughts. That was a decent fish too. Yeah, he was just, they're not on it. They're just really light. Actually, there might be a little bit of a burr on that. When they bite light like that, you just lift up and they're there. Mm-hmm. You stick them good. That's a little better. There we go. Put a little bio wedge on and voila.
Got one.
Little guy. Sharpen the hooks. Seems to be making a difference with the bio edge too. The biggest one off a dock? Actually, I think the biggest largemouth that I ever caught was off a dock. 7'4", 7'6", something like that. He feels like a better one. Oh, maybe he's okay. Not a bad little chunk. He was in there. Holy jumping. 6 inches. Did you see how dry his back was? Holy jumping. Oh, that was good fish. Oh, he's not as good as I thought he was. You got that? Alrighty.
That was fast.
Yeah.
Fast on the follow-up, good job.
You gotta be quick sometimes. Oh, little guy. Sometimes they make a lot of commotion and look bigger than they are.
I guess I don't know if you want to call them goals, but some of the achievements I want to accomplish are, you know, or back, you know, going back 5, 8 years ago, 10 years ago was, you know, I want to be angler of the year. I want to be team of the year. I want to win a classic. I've won a tournament, at least one tournament on almost every lake that we fish. I think Simcoe still eludes me a little bit, but other than that, I have never won a classic on any of the bodies of water. So that is a big goal for me.
How many tournaments have you won?
I have won, I think it's somewhere around 11 or 12. Nice. I've had over 70 top 10s, and all multi-species, not just bass either, like crappie, walleye, and bass.
Oh, there's a fish. Come on, eat it. Oh, that's a big one too. I just ripped her lips off. Set? I think I... Damn. Looks like she flared her gills. I thought she went on it. What was that? A sunfish, I think. Ooh, they came flying out.
Good one. There he is.
Yeah, come here, baby. Come on. There she is. That's what we're talking about. It was just popping. I slowed it down a little bit. Wasn't going so fast, and there she be. Put some bio edge on her, and that's what happens. See you later, baby.